Hello guys, my name is Pavel Křupala from BlenderFeed.com and welcome to the part number 11 of the Node Editor tutorial series. And in this part we are starting to implement the logic of the dragging edge. We won't be doing any graphical stuff in this part, but we will implement the logic into the console for now. And we will make sure that it works 100% correctly. So there will be two types of creating edge for now. So we can click and release, then click again up to the end socket. And as you can see, we are actually recognizing that we need to assign the edge to the socket. So if we click anywhere else, we end dragging edge, but we are not assigning any end socket. So we can click and drag and then release. And this will be the other option which we can use for creating a new edge. So I hope you are excited and let's start coding. Okay, so let's spend some time talking about what we are going actually to implement. And the functionality I want to implement is will be this. So if we have socket on our node like this, and we will have another node, let's say like this one, then the first functionality I want to have is left mouse button click and drag up to the end socket. So I start clicking here. I want to see something like a dashed line, which will notice me that I'm actually dragging an edge. And once I release it, for example, here in this socket, this line will change back to the regular edge, which we already know. So this is the first functionality. So the second functionality we can have, and I want it to be here too. If I click on a socket and then I release the mouse button, so left mouse button click and release, then I can start seeing another dashed line, which will be our drag edge. And nice feature about having this one implemented is that here I can middle mouse click and I can move the scene around. So if the nodes are getting complicated or too big, I can move around and then connect it to correct socket, which I want. After I go to some socket, like for example this one in this case, and I again left mouse button click, I will set up the end socket. And again, this will change back to the regular solid edge. Okay, I can draw, but it doesn't matter. So here, huge exclamation mark, we do need the zooming and the padding of the scene to remain untouched. So we need it to be functional. And the last functionality which I do want to see in a node editor, definitely, I will draw it with the green one, is that when we do have some edges connected already, we can probably go, let's say here, and we can control click this socket. And once we do this, I do want this edge to be again going to change to end drag edge, so I can choose a different socket which the edge will actually lead. So the first one will be control left mouse button click on an existing edge or socket, existing socket, change to drag edge again. So these three things I do want to implement, so let's go ahead and start coding. Okay, so let's start implement the logic. First off, we want to somehow detect if we clicked on a socket. So as you probably guess, we already implemented mouse move override method of the Q graphic item. The same way we can type mouse press event and print out socket was clicked. And when I press play and I click anywhere, nothing is happening until I click on a socket, then the socket was clicked. But let's think about for a moment, where do we actually want to implement our logic of creating a new edge or dragging the edge around? Probably if this class is supposed to handle just the rendering of the socket itself, it wouldn't be a great place to start creating a new edges or anything, so we can probably move this up the hierarchy. Socket is inside of the node, node is inside of the scene, but the scene is handling only the rendering of the scene itself, and above one level there is a node graphic view. And maybe as you can recall, we already started to implement mouse press events and we divided the left right mouse buttons, and I see there is a mistake here. This should be left mouse button press, like this. So we could probably go here and start implementing this logic here. So I will delete the return because it's not necessary. We are not returning anything. Neither we are supposed to return anything. So first off, I wanna know if what's the item which I clicked on. So let's create a new method and call it get item at click and pass the event. This method will be really simple. So define get item at click self event, and we can retrieve the position of the click by calling event.pos like this, and we can recall the object in this view exactly where we clicked by calling item at and passing the position. So therefore we can return obj, the object itself, and this should work. So let's test it out again. I got none. Here is a graphic node. Here is, if I can, okay, here is a graphic edge bezier. This one is a graphic text item, so that's the label of the node. Proxy widget, graphic node, and this one is QDM graphic socket. So now we can test if the type of the item is QDM graphics socket, then we can print out socket was clicked. And let's go ahead and import from node graphic socket import QDM graphic socket. Nothing, and socket was clicked, so this one works. So once we click on a socket, we are going to start dragging an edge. To make it a little bit simpler, we can go ahead and say that self mode will equal to, let's call it mode edge drag. So we will create something like a state machine. So when the application starts, the self mode should be mode no operation, and let's define the constant. So mode no operation will be 1 and mode edge drag will be 2. So in case we clicked on the left mouse button and the self mode is equal to mode no operation, then we will definitely set up the mode to mode edge dragging. So first off, I will implement just print so we can block out the code, so we can see what we are actually implementing in the logic, and we will try ourselves as much as possible to make it as much understandable as possible and as much clean as possible. The reason why, it's a good practice to keep your logic at one place, simple enough and easily readable, so you can anytime go and change that again. Another reason is that if you visit or revisit your code after a year or two, you will thank yourself that you have written the code the way that you can simply understand it just by reading itself. Let's print out start dragging edge, and we basically know that we clicked socket, so the next thing we are going to do is print assign start socket. This is the next command we are going to do or call. Click, nothing happened, start dragging an edge and assign start socket. So once we click on some empty space or anything else than a socket, we will stop dragging the edge. That's the next thing we are going to do. But let me talk about this line here. I want to show you one thing. So when I click here and start dragging, you can see nothing is happening, which is correct. But notice this thing. If I move around to the node and I'm still over the socket and I click and start dragging, the whole node is moving. And this is not the behavior we actually want. We want all this socket area to be controlling only the socket, not the node itself. So the reason why this is possible is because we are passing the event to call above in the upper classes, in the parents. So this actually causes that the event is going one level up and the next level up until it meets the node, and there is the logic for the moving of the node implemented. So except of calling this mousePress event here, we can go ahead and decide that if we click on a socket, we are starting to drag an edge, we are assigning start socket, and then we can call return. So we can end up this method, and if anything else is going to happen, we do want to preserve the mouse click event as it's supposed to be. So let's try that again. And when I click here and start dragging, you can see that the node itself is not moving. Okay, so this works. Then we can go ahead and we can type that if the self mode is equal to mode edge drag, and I'm moving this two levels back, so we are not under this if condition anymore, because if we click on anything, we definitely always wanna set the mode to no operation, and we are going to end dragging edge. So we are basically going to disable the dragging edge itself. But there is a special case if we click on a socket again. So if the type is item, the type parenthesis item is QDM graphics socket. So we clicked on a socket. That means we are going to assign end socket. And after this, we should probably continue and call the parent mouse press event. But if you clicked on a socket, we don't want to continue, so we will definitely return here. And let's test it out. I start clicking. Now I should be able to see a drag edge with a dashed line. And once I click on anything else, for example this thing, the end dragging edge is being called, so we are disabling the dragging edge. So let's go ahead and try that again. We are again dragging an edge. We already got a starting socket, and when we click on another socket, the end dragging edge is being called and we are assigning the end socket, which works perfectly as we wanted to. So that's our first case, or the second case. The first one is when I click and drag, and then I release above the socket, we should be able to end dragging edge and assign the end socket. So let's go ahead and start implementing this one. So we are going here to the left mouse button release, and let's retrieve the item. Self get item at click event, and if the type of the item is QDM graphics socket, then we will definitely set the mode back to mode no operation. We will print out the end dragging edge. And maybe we are supposed to end the edge dragging mode anytime we release the mouse button. So if self.mode equals to mode edge drag, let this be the self mode no operation. And in case the type item is QDM graphics socket, then we are going to assign end socket and we are going to return. And as you can see right now, the code is exactly the same here and here, so we are already starting to repeat ourselves, which is not cool. So let's test this out. So start dragging edge, I am still holding the left mouse button, and I release, and there is end dragging edge. Should be like this. So let's try it again. Okay, so this is cool, this works. And now when I release the left mouse button over the socket, assigning the end socket. If I just click and release, there is start dragging edge, and immediately there is going to be an end dragging edge. So we can extend this condition here, and we can say something that if mouse has not moved enough, then do nothing. Otherwise, call this logic. So what is this supposed to be? We can implement logic that if we click and release here, this will be ignored. The logic of the end dragging edge will be ignored. So for that, we do need to know where are we actually clicking and where we clicked before. So if we go up here, we can create a variable and let's call it last left mouse button click scene position, and this will be self map to scene, and we will call that with event.pos like this. And here we can retrieve the new left mouse button position release scene position, and this one will be again self map to scene event.position like this. So now we can print out the distance of the scene position between our clicks, and this one will be new minus self last left mouse button click scene position distance on click and release, and this one will be dist scene pos. After that we are going to test if this works or not. So in our case it crashes, so I will type if false, or maybe not, 1 = 2, which will never going to happen. Then we are going to pass OK, so I clicked, dragged and released, and you can see our distance on click and release is 94 and 7. If I just click on the socket and keep it, the Q point F is nothing, that means 0, 0. So basically if we start clicking and drag and quickly release, we got the distance something about 10. So probably if we are starting to drag the edge quickly and release it or move it before we release the mouse button, we can count some threshold for detection of this this actual drag. I don't know if it makes sense, but hopefully I will explain it further as I start typing that. So the allowed, first off we need to count distance of this new vector. So if you got a vector which is from x and y coordinates, then you probably know that the distance of the vector or the magnitude is square root of x multiplied by x plus y multiplied by y. There is one problem with that, and that's when x and y will be 0, then we are basically calling sqrt from 0, which will crash because this is not defined. And later, or here on this spot, we will be checking the current distance of this vector here with our threshold. So that means we are going to check something like this. So basically we can go ahead and do some optimization, and we can remove this square root and multiply the threshold by 2, or make it squared. So do something like this for our condition. So for that we can define the threshold. So this will be edge drag start threshold, and let's say this will be 10 pixels. So let's start typing this condition. If this is going to be less than our edge drag threshold, and multiply by itself, so it's squared. And here we can probably rename this to dist scene. We can check if dist scene.x multiplied by dist scene.x plus dist scene.y multiplied by dist scene.y is less than edge drag start threshold, then we are basically ignoring the release mouse button and we don't want to do anything, so that should probably left us in the mode edge dragging. So the next time we click, we can end it as a logic set, and if we drag the mouse a little bit further than our threshold, then we are going to check for this logic. So let's try that out. So if I click, I'm starting drag edge. Once I click again, I end dragging edge. And I click and hold, I'm dragging an edge. Once I release, there is end dragging edge. So let's test if it takes the socket and dragging edge. Okay, this works. And I start dragging edge. I release the mouse button immediately, so I should be able to view what's going on. And as you can see, I can drag around, I can zoom, and still I'm in a dragging edge mode with assigned starting socket. So once I click again with the left mouse button here, I will assign the end socket. So this actually works. And let's go ahead and clean up the code a little bit. So basically this code repeats itself here. So let's create a function for that. Define, let's call it a little bit better, drag edge, or maybe edge drag. And we are going to pass item where we clicked. So this is always going to be this. And now we need to solve this return. So we can basically return true if we wanna skip the rest of the code. Otherwise we will return false. So return false. And if we want to return, we are going to call this return true. So that means we are going to call self edge drag end and pass the item, and here will be the result, which can be true if you wanna skip. So if result, then return. But this way we will keep this logic on one method and we won't repeat ourselves. So we can go ahead and copy these two lines and call them here. What we can do next is we can rid of this part here. So if we just switch this condition, then we don't need the else anymore. And probably we can move this logic up to a separate function again. So let's call that distance between click and release is off. That's an ugly name for a method, but whatever. At least as descriptive. So for this one, we are going to need the event, which will be this. And we are going to return this, all of this as a condition. So return. And this will be distance x x plus y y is bigger than edge drag star threshold. Edge drag threshold squared, because I just don't like it to be so long. So return if this is bigger than edge drag threshold squared. So if self dot distance between click and release is off, then we are going to call this code. So let's comment this. Get item which we clicked on. And here is going to be the logic. We can basically clean this up. Okay. So this measures if we are too far from the last left mouse button click scene position, like this. Okay, and we can move these two functions somewhere else. So here we have middle mouse, left mouse and the right mouse button, and we can probably paste them here. So let's write a comment here too. Return the object on which we have clicked or released the mouse button. Like this. Okay, this is commented too. And now this should work. So let's start play. Click and crash. Why did it crash? Edge drag end, because we didn't pass the event, right? Click and release, I should be dragging, and end. Click, dragging and holding, and release, that works too. This ends. Okay, this seems to be working. Awesome. So let's clean this a little bit. Which we clicked on. Which we released. Mouse button on. Here we store the position of last left mouse button click And here goes the logic. Okay, so that's cool. And you know what? As I'm looking at the code, I don't like these two calls here. So let's go ahead and create function which will be self edge drag start, and maybe we can pass the item. And let's go down here and define edge drag start self item and put the code here. Okay. And this way it's a little bit cleaner and I like it much more. You can keep this self mode setting up here so we don't need to move it down to the methods, so we can immediately see that if we are actually in the mode null operation, we are changing the mode here in this logic here. Okay, yeah, nice and clean. So thank you for watching. I hope you learned something and see you at the next part when we are starting to code the actual graphical representation of the dragging edge.